Hello, fellas, and welcome back to my channel. My name is me, Kip Bowman, and thank you so much to invite me back to the new video. I'm glad you can join me. I hope you appreciate my support, and thank you so much for subscribing to my channel. I'm glad you are came to return my channel. I'm sure you're quite new. About how fantastic you are, guys. Thank you so much for splendid comments you made me. So about last week I watched a final part of Red Dwarf, the first 3 million years retrospective documentary. So remember last time about the first part, when a portion of Dwarf has reached 3 million views, has successfully achieved. I can't believe how outrageous that is. So we just moved on to a third final part of Retrospective Red Dwarf Documentary. We're just now barely focused on playing pool with planets. It has been narrated by David Tenant once again. So let's talk about scientific theories. It's basically referred to a concept from an early series, early episodes of Red Dwarf. That was from Whitehall, backwards, Skipper, and Back to Reality, and Gunmen of Apocalypse. That's a really good episode of about time travel. Which, according to Backwards, one episode called Backwards, when a quick shot was being filmed, it's only one footage in being filmed in forwards, he walked backwards. A quick shot could not hear him, could hear the director say action. He almost got ended up drowning. I cannot resist that. This is more interesting about why here the behind the scenes of Red Dwarf, what history was referred to. Back in three, which is focused on setting the future predictions. It's actually really interesting. This we had an experience of what Red Dwarf so successful. He was so smegging funny. It was a great British sitcom comedy in history. And nevertheless, I know original cast members. You had a really extensive roles that got put into them in production. I know the actors were already recognised. It was Craig Charles, Robert Wellin, David John Jules, Chris Barry, Mac McDonald, and Chloe Annett and Claire Grogan. I guess you recognise these people, and including Norman Lafette, Hattie Haywich. They did amazing roles of Red Dwarf. They did splendid ways of how Red Dwarf can change over 30 years. Since it's been originally broadcast on BBC Two since February 1988, I guess you're quite unaware of that, especially when we learned from Peter Wag, well, he was previously did on model units. When he did, he was working with Jerry Anderson. He used to do some interior sets and models. He used to take on position to shoot on Thunderbirds and the Captain Scarlet. I guess you already have recognised this familiar shows, science fiction shows back in the 1960s. I can't believe how classic it is. I know how Rob Grant and Doug Nail do have excellent scientific theories, which can make a whole TV series become phenomenal classic of Red Dwarf. Okay. Well, although, if some of you are quite unaware, on 1992, West when NBC trying to intend to get a US remake of the British version of Red Dwarf. I know, but the whole Thai show, American version of Red Dwarf, is quite not very impressive. It seems a bit unfairly criticised. I know Craig Charles doesn't like the US version of Red Dwarf. He didn't like it. There was a few actors did the roles of John Levis, Craig Falco, and Chris Eggman. And we have a guest star, we had appearance from Red Dwarf. You guys might also recognise them, if you're quite familiar with. It was Sarah Alexander, Johnny Vegas, and Helen George, Don Harrington, and there is Timothy Spall. You guys who recognise them. If you're quite familiar with some, you might recognise them in Hollywood films or either British shows. I guess you might recognise them. And on Series 7, Dave Lister's love interest named Christine Kachansky, who was originally played by Claire Grogan, a Scottish actress and pop singer. She made her first appearance in The End. Then, in the younger counterpart of Christine Kachansky in Paolo version, she's been replaced by Chloe Annette. She also made another appearance in Series 8. That was the final season broadcasted by BBC 2. Then, because BBC has been disliked to continue a show, then they just moved on to the digital network, Dave. Red Dwarf wasn't being broadcasted back in early 2000s, not until the actors from Red Dwarf came back into costumes. In an Easter special in 2009 called Red Dwarf Back to Earth, which came in three parts, obviously. You know how, remember David Ross was the original version of Crichton? He did not come back to reprise Crichton in the third series. So, instead, he's been replaced by Robert Erlin. He has been first appeared in Series 3. And now how, what reactions or the audience can appeal to Red Dwarf series, it can stay loyal. And especially David Ross was being voiced by, being, he voiced Talkie Toaster. So, Talkie Toaster again. And when a specific character, well, Lister doesn't want any toast, he says, "Ah, sorry, a rubber man." I know how, I can't believe how I enjoyed watching Red Dwarf so far, since I was a kid. And when Hollywood Studios produced Red Dwarf special, was broadcasted on street on UKTV platform. It was called Red Dwarf the Promised Land. I guess I enjoyed that. It was quite funny and more entertaining. So it's about it really. I hope you all smegheads enjoy watching this video. I guess you appreciate it. So I guess you haven't seen Red Dwarf so much. It was quite absolute phenomenal, awesome, and smegging funny. There's another character named A Swimmer. He was first appeared in Dimension Jump. When Chris Barry was bored playing Arnold Wimmer, he got moved on to Space James Bond style. I'll be back for breakfast. Okay, right, thank you so much for your time. Thank you so much for watching. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel and to hit the bell for notification. And please do not miss out the new videos twice a week. It's gonna be posted on Wednesday, every two Wednesdays, every two Fridays, every two Tuesdays, and every two Thursdays. It depends if I'm at college or if I'm, because I'm attending in day centres on Thursdays. Please find me on social links. You can find me on Instagram, Twitter, Pinterest, my Facebook page, TikTok, and Snapchat. If some people don't have Snapchat and TikTok or Pinterest or don't have Facebook that much, don't use Facebook that much. And you can find me on Twitter, Instagram, and YouTube. If some people get overwhelmed about finding me on, because it's a bit difficult to find, but it's easy for me too. It's easy for you to find me on YouTube. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you enjoyed my video. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you were impressed with my Red Dwarf retrospective documentary so far. I know you have watched some old documentaries of Red Dwarf. There was Smeg Ups and Smeg Outs. Okay, I hope you see you soon. And please stay healthy and stay safe through COVID-19 pandemic. I hope you see you soon. See ya.